Do you feel that India's complexity, because of its massive population, and for thousands of years we have the Bhagavad Gita, we have the Ramayana, have we confused ourselves, and now we have gone into self-destruct? And what's the way forward?
Okay, the way forward is, suppose there are different strands of Hinduism. You've got different scriptures, different. Look, if you are in North India, different way of thinking about religion. If you're in Tamil Nadu, it's different way of thinking about religion. Different festivals, different gods and goddesses given favor. Nothing wrong. Tremendous variation, very colorful variation throughout India. Huge, vast. Look, more the merrier. But then, as the gentleman says, one of the drawbacks when you have many approaches, it can create confusion and conflict too. Because suppose I believe in God as my essential nature, and my mom says, no, Mataji, mother goddess. Unless I'm very careful, I'm going to have a problem in the house. So it can cause, pluralism can cause conflict, if you're not very careful, can definitely cause confusion, as the gentleman pointed out, because there are so many ways, I'm getting a headache now, which is right? Maybe right in the morning, I thought this was right, in the afternoon, I said, no, that's not right, this one. So I get confused and I kind of get scattered. This is the price we pay for pluralism. This is the price we pay for democracy. When you allow many variations, it can create, it's the price you have to pay, like a tax you have to pay. So this is, if you like, how do you solve it, the final part? By reconciling different pathways, reconciling. Let me, try and plug in something very important. The person, one individual who really reconciled the different strands of Hinduism in one lifetime and projected it for the world stage is my mentor. And his name is Swami Vivekananda. In one lifetime, this person in 2 minutes can go deep meditation where he sees himself as the spirit. In next minute, he can see God, not himself, in other human beings and really charge them up. Here is, if you like, one individual who systematically reconciled the various strands of Hinduism. And one of the great professors in the West here, Ninian Smart, said something very interesting. He said, before Vivekananda, Hinduism was a scattered enterprise, not reconciled, not sitting well with each other parts, different parts kind of at conflict with each other, kind of floating in the air, different strands. This one man managed to reconcile seamlessly the different strands of Hinduism as a very, very compact, like a very well reconciled, very well thought out and very well structured, mature religion. So the solution is focus on the reconciliation. When you say variation, say, look, I'll give an example. Suppose somebody likes to think God like a father. Somebody like to think of God like his mother. How do you reconcile? A little funny story, lighten up. I may have done it here before. I go to many Catholic schools and I do lectures there and assemblies. And they say, Mr. Lakhani, tell us about Hinduism. And they're sitting cross-legged, hundreds of little children. Oh, they must tell us. I say, okay, sure. And my first question I say to the Hindu, to the Christian Catholic children is, mostly Catholic schools. I say, do you like to think of God like your father in heaven? And they look at each other. It's a trick question. Of course we, this is our Christian prayer. Who is asking silly question like they look at each other. Like, God like your father in heaven? They all nod their heads. I say, yes, good idea. Many Hindus like the God like a father called Vishnu or Shiva. It's a good idea, I said. But you see that little chap in the corner? He keeps tugging my sleeve. He said, I don't want God to be my daddy. Why not? He couldn't. No, he said, I don't want God to be my daddy. What's your problem? He said, the problem is simple. Last night when I was having supper, some food fell accidentally on the floor. My daddy saw it. He stood up. He waved his finger at me, said, naughty boy, no supper, no TV, go to your room. And I was crying. And my mommy came into the room and she saw me crying. She said, come here, my baby. And she gave me a hug. And then she gave me a jam donut. Why should I think of God like my daddy? My daddies are so rough and tough and so hairy. I rather think of God as my mommy in heaven. They're sweet and kind and they give jam donuts. I said, my boy, you like to think God like your mom in heaven? God is your mom in heaven. Go for it. This is called pluralism. Depending on your own temperament, the way you relate to spirituality will reflect your own mindset. It cannot be otherwise. In fact, all the prophets did the same thing. When they tried to express the idea of spirituality, their own mindset kicked in. So one said, I see Father in heaven. Others said, I see burning bushes. The third said, I'm just enlightened. No father figure, just enlightened, I'm Buddha. So you see, the same spiritual experience produced different expressions depending on the mindset of the prophets. But this reconciliation is the marvelous way Then you see the variation. You smile when you see. You like when you go to for dinner. Don't you like the variation? When you see religion or spirituality present in this variation, with colorful variation, you smile at this reconciled at the deeper level.